EuroFX bounces on the opening, and some people are pointing to the revisions that the EU made with regards to growth and inflation. They upgraded their inflation forecast to 6.1% in 2022, and growth was revised down to 2.7%. That said, money markets in the Eurozone turned a little bit hawkish, seeing about 10 basis points added to the chances of a rate hike compared to Friday. Also, ECB Governing Council member Villeroy, who came out in the newswire saying that the June meeting will be decisive while moving to neutral. Also, some dollar negative news over the weekend with regards to Goldman Sachs senior chair Blankfein, who himself thinks that the chances of a U.S. recession are very, very high. Also, Goldman Sachs cut their growth forecast for the U.S. Down to 2.4 from 2.6 back in February. The bulk of our session, EuroFX, actually end up bouncing and then retreating around the flat line. U.S. data wasn't very good. The Empire Manufacturing Report continued to bring broad apprehension in the market. Prices paid were eased. Prices received were lower. New shipments and new orders were both off. The only bright spot, according to the data, was that the number of employees improved. That said, the EuroFX continued to monitor. It seemed like monitoring risk assets were very wobbly today with regards to treasury yields, the stock market, and even cryptocurrency. Also heard from Fed President Williams speaking at a mortgage symposium. Nothing said out of the ordinary. Moving into options, I look at CME Group CVOL and EuroFX in June, 1 month basis trading to 60th percentile, 3 month basis to 50th percentile. At the money vols are moderately lower, while skew is actually higher as the down variance is down in the day, whereas the call variance or up variance basically unchanged. Option volume spread out between the 104 and 105 strikes, also seeing volume in a 105 call, 103 half put. Lastly, CME Group E-Micro Mini Futures and the EuroFX continue to grow. Friday's volume was 5,313. Open interest, 14,786.